Hi, Randy Orr with Berkshire Hathaway and the Orr Group here in Laguna Niguel, Orange County, California. I want to bring you the latest housing report. It is November 29th, 2021. We're almost to the end of the year. And I want to discuss two components of why the market is as strong as it is. Number one, I want to discuss our inventory level, and that'll be a short discussion. And then a little bit longer discussion is going to be the talk that I'd like to do on loan limits and where they are and why it will help and assist buyers buy at a higher price point going into 2022. So let me first discuss our inventory situation. Last week at this time, we had about 35, 36 homes active on the marketplace. In the city of Laguna Niguel, the entire zip code, the entire city of Laguna Niguel, we had 35, 36 homes on the market. That level is significantly lower than what it normally is. Normally we're at least 100, sometimes up to 150, even at this time of the year. We're experiencing a huge sell-off and we are actually having a shrinking inventory level, a net shrinkage, where today we have 26 homes on the market in the entire city of Laguna Niguel. I capture this data every Monday, which reflects the sell-off on the weekend, and there will continue to be sell-off, of course, Monday and Tuesday with some consummated sales happening today and tomorrow for the week. So having said that, we're experiencing a low inventory level, which is making it difficult for buyers to find homes, fueling the high prices that we're seeing that sellers are commanding for their homes. But why is the market going to remain strong for the remainder of this year into 2022? And that's a function of loan rates, but along with loan rates are loan rate caps. In other words, how much can a borrower borrow at certain rates going into the next year? So to give you an idea, in 2020, the first tier of pricing was capped at $510,400. You could have a loan limit of $510,400 for that first tier. And in certain marketplaces, Orange County being one, there's that luxury tier or the tier above it before you get into jumbo loans. And we are one of about 100 marketplaces in the United States that have that in-between luxury rate before you get into jumbo. So I'll cover that in just a second. But let's talk about the first entry level tier, which in 2020 was $510,400, and in 2021, this year, it went to $548,250. So it went up significantly, about $40,000+, giving that borrower that much more buying power. In other words, able to stretch the loan about $40,000+ at a higher price point property. It is anticipated that going into 2022, the Fed is going to raise that cap to about $650,000. What does that do for a conventional loan at 20% down, for example? It allows a buyer to buy a property up to $812,500. That's raising it from where it was this year to a higher level of $812,000 to keep up with the rising prices that we're seeing in homes. There is another level, which is not a jumbo loan, but it's a higher tier. And for 2020, that tier was capped at $765,600. For 2021, it went to $822,375. That's a significant jump. We are anticipating, as it hasn't been announced yet, but we're anticipating that cap to be raised to a $975,000 loan amount. Now, what does that do for a fixed loan amount, conventional loan, at that higher price point, the luxury price point? It allows a 20% down borrower with a loan limit of $975,000 to be able to buy a purchase price of $1,218,750. That hovers about $200,000 above our median sales price, which is just a little bit between $1 million and $1.1 million. But that extension of a loan cap, in addition to the low rates that we're currently enjoying for a buyer, gives the buyer more buying power going into next year, 2022, which is why the market will remain strong. We will see low inventory levels, making it difficult to acquire a property, but the market is anticipated to be very, very strong in favor of the seller, but making it easier for buyers to qualify with lower rates at higher price points as far as adjusting to the marketplace. Now, there are other loan programs. There's FHA, there's VA loans that that allow buyers to buy also with low interest rates or lower interest rates. And those are just a few of the reasons. I wanted to really make this as simple as I can to make it understandable going into, you know, the season of buying next year. So I hope this is of value. I will continue to provide valuable information for both buyers and sellers. Randy Orr with Berkshire Hathaway, changing lives one home at a time.